Today, we're going to create a deck of cards in Python. All we are starting out with is two lists, one list containing the rank of the cards, and a list containing the suits of the cards. I added in the actual card symbols to the code because I feel like that adds a bit of extra flair as opposed to just writing the word like H-E-A-R-T, heart, out. On a regular playing card, say you have the ace of spades, the rank in that case would be ace, and the suit will be spades, just so we all know the terminology we're working with. Now, we could make each card a dictionary with a key of string rank pointing to the card's rank and a key of string suit pointing to the card's rank, but are you probably watching this in the first place because your teacher told you to use object-oriented programming? You are. First, we'll make the card class. A class's double underscore init method is its constructor. It is the function that puts the object together when you make a new one in other code. We're going to make our two members rank and then suit, because normally you say ace of spades, not spade of ace. And then the normal boilerplate in your constructor, self.rank equals rank, self.suit equals suit. And each card also has a numeric value, self.value, but we'll come in and fill that in later. So as we have it written right now, let's make our own code and see if we can make an ace of spades. C equals card rank ace. Suit spades. And we'll go over to the command line and see if we can print it out. Oh, we didn't print it out. Print C. And you see it prints out this nonsense double underscore main card object at numbers. This is because when Python was made, there's no way they could possibly enumerate all the different objects you could make in the code the standard way that they print out an object when you make a new one. To get what one would expect, we need to use a double underscore str method. This is telling Python how it should represent your object as a string if you ever try to print it out. In other words, it's much simpler to just define this method that prints out an object's attributes one at a time. So we will just make this double underscore str method return the F string of the card's rank followed by the card's value. That's the whole str method. Now we'll go back to filling in the value in the constructor. We're going to make this a separate function. A class method called calcValue. And we need to pass in rank to calcValue because it's a class method, so it won't have access to the rank value. And I'm making this separate calcValue method because a constructor should construct. That's it. Let's start the function off with an if statement. For the first line in this if statement, we can just do if rank.isDigit, then return the string rank converted to an integer. This covers if the rank is anywhere between 2 and 10. Now for the ace, elif rank equals ace. Generally, an ace's value is going to be 1, but of course, if it's something different in your game, you can just change this line. Next up, we'll worry about the jack and queen. Elif rank equals jack or rank equals queen. Again, generally, these guys will equal 10, but that could change in your game. Finally, we'll deal with the king. Elif rank equals king. And in my favorite card game, the value of a king is 0. So I'll do that. But that's it for the card class. Now we'll move on and make the deck class. We'll start off with the constructor. We will start off with an empty list for our cards. That'll end up being the whole standard 52 card deck. Then we'll move down our ranks and suits from before into the constructor. Next, it is just a classic 2D for loop. For R in ranks, for S in suits, append to the cards variable, constructing a new card. After this, you'll want to make sure your completed deck is shuffled. So for now, we will just write self.shuffleDeck, even though we know that method is not defined yet. Depending on how well versed you are in Python, you probably know the next step. We're going to need shuffling functionality, so we will go up top and type from random import shuffle. Back down in the deck class, we will define the shuffle deck method. It takes in self as its only argument, and then the method is a simple one-liner. Use the shuffle functionality. We import it to shuffle the cards variable. Finally, you'll want to deal a card from this deck, so we will define a deal method that takes in only self. Since we shuffled the deck back in the constructor, it doesn't matter where we pull the card out of because the whole deck is randomized, so we will make it very simple. Just return the result of calling pop on the cards variable. Which is storing our deck of cards. That's it. That's how to create a deck of cards in Python. This has been Jakubication.
Like and subscribe to learn more.